We're back here in the lab at Midtronics. We've got our 2010 Cadillac Escalade Hybrid that we've had an inGEN data recorder installed on, where we're looking to get some baseline data on this particular vehicle type. Let's get in a little bit tighter and make sure that we're going to get a look at the lens and see if the vehicle has gone dark yet or if we're still alive after they just pulled it into the bay. Let's take a look. Okay, you can see we've got a little bit of road splash here that the module's been exposed to. Just good common sense that when you're installing these modules, make sure that if there's a chance of some additional splash, you can put anything you want protectively, a blanket, a plastic sheet, something to keep the road splash off of the module if it's going to be at risk. Let's take a look at this module. I'm going to take the bonnet off and kind of zoom in to see if we can get a look at the actual data as we're seeing it. We're measuring 12.52 volts, and essentially it's toggling between 10 and 20 milliamps of current draw, and it is logging data. We can see that on the screen. To be prepared to properly remove the IDR-10, we're going to take our PSC550 power supply unit, hook it up to the vehicle, and make sure that we have the proper voltage that we're not going to drop in any of the presets when we break that negative cable again to remove the data logger. We've got our PSC550 power unit in place. It's hooked up. We can see I've got our AC power available. I'm going to turn the switch on so that we see our regulated voltage comes back up. Now we're safe to go ahead and support the vehicle loads while we break that negative cable to do the extraction on the IDR-10 module. All right, with the power supply in place, we can see we're at our regulated voltage. We're still taking a little bit of charge energy here into the battery, but we're going to go ahead and stop the log file. So we have to hit exit and then stop. We hit enter for the stop. Now it's safe to remove the SD card, and we've got our data captured here that we can go ahead and look at with the DAS data analysis software. For removing the unit, to keep it simple, the first thing I like to do, once we've stopped the log file and we have our data secure, I'll simply go ahead and remove the power lead from the module. It's powered down and we're good to go. I'm also going to go ahead and take this cable piece and remove it off the positive terminal on the battery. Now, because we've got lots of slack here, we'll remove this tape, undo the latch. The vehicle is now running on the power supply unit only. Now we'll take and loosen the battery terminal. Spread that apart just a little bit. Put the module on the bench. Position and reconnect our negative cable. Now that we've got the module removed and we've supported the vehicle with the battery, we can take our power supply unit, turn it off, extract that from under a hood, and we'll be ready to go and take a look at some data actually on the PC. We'll find out what happened for the couple days this unit was installed.